Hello and welcome to the news from Bahrain International. I'm Hiba Abdul Ghaffar. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received yesterday at Sakhir Palace. Senior officials of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, heads of missions of the Kingdom of Bahrain abroad, and kingdom's accredited heads of diplomatic missions on the occasion of the Golden Jubilee of Bahraini Diplomacy and Diplomatic Day, which falls on January 14, 2019. At the beginning of the meeting, the attendees greeted His Majesty the King.
السلام عليكم. السلام. الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. للذين استجابوا لربهم الحسنى والذين لم يستجيبوا له لو أن لهم ما في الأرض جميعا ومثله معه لافتدوا به أولئك لهم سوء الحساب ومأواهم جهنم وبئس المهاد. أفمن يعلم أنما أنزل إليك من ربك الحق كمن هو أعمى إنما يتذكر أولو الألباب. الذين يوفون بعهد الله ولا ينقضون الميثاق والذين يصلون ما أمر الله به أن يوصل ويخشون ربهم ويخافون سوء الحساب. والذين صبروا ابتغاء وجه ربهم وأقاموا الصلاة وأنفقوا مما رزقناهم سرا وعلانية ويدرؤون بالحسنة السيئة أولئك لهم عقبى الدار. جنات عدن يدخلونها ومن صلح من آبائهم وأزواجهم وذرياتهم والملائكة يدخلون عليهم من كل باب. سلام عليكم بما صبرتم فنعم عقبى الدار. صدق الله العظيم.
بارك الله فيكم. بارك الله.
يتفضل سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلالة الملك حمد بن عيسى الخليفة ملك البلاد المفدى حفظه الله ورعى بإلقاء كلمة
His Majesty the King then delivered a speech on the occasion.
بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. أصحاب السمو والمعالي، أصحاب السعادة السفراء، نرحب بالجميع أجمل ترحيب، ويسعدنا أن نفتتح عامنا الجديد ببلوغ الذكرى 50 لبدء العمل الدبلوماسي المنظم الذي استطعنا من خلال مسيرته الثرية أن نطلع العالم على الهوية الرصينة لسياسة مملكة البحرين الخارجية الملتزمة بتعزيز التضامن العالمي والارتقاء بالأمن الإنساني. ولقد أوضحت تجاربنا في هذا المجال بقدرة الدبلوماسية البحرينية على التفهم والإدراك التام للمتطلبات وللمتغيرات الدولية بتحدياتها المختلفة، وهو ما مكن بلادنا من التعاطي الدبلوماسي المهني والموضوعي في مختلف الظروف وصياغة المواقف الخارجية الحريصة على الصالح العام التي تأخذ في الاعتبار التوازن بين أولوياتها الاستراتيجية والتزاماتها الدولية. دون إقفال لأهمية النقل الدقيق لجهود تنميتنا الوطنية المستمرين في تطويرها، والتي توثق نتائجها المتقدمة العديد من التقارير الدولية. كما نجحت البحرين عبر نظام عملها الدبلوماسي في بناء شبكة قوية من التحالفات والشراكات الدولية القائمة على أسس احترام سيادة الدول وحسن الجوار، ومد جسور التفاهم وتغريب وجهات النظر في كافة القضايا. وهو أمر يؤكد بأن نهج علاقاتنا الدبلوماسية القائم على حسن النوايا هو ما اعتدنا عليه ولن نتخلى عنه، بكونه فطرة حضارية نشأت عليها الطبيعة البحرينية الودودة والمنفتحة على العالم. وبهذه المناسبة الطيبة يسرنا أن نتوجه بالشكر العميق والامتنان الكبير لمؤسسي العمل الدبلوماسي الوطني ومن يواصل على دربهم لجهودهم الحثيثة في إيصال صوت البحرين الواثق المجسد لصورتها الإيجابية والمرسخ لسياستها الخارجية الداعمة لخير العالم واستقراره، مع تطلعنا لاستمرار جهود التطوير وخصوصا في مجال تنمية الكفاءات واستثمار الخبرات ورفع مستويات التخصصية في العمل الدبلوماسي. ونوجه بهذا الشأن بأن يتم تطوير المعهد الدبلوماسي بتحويله إلى أكاديمية خاصة للدراسات الدبلوماسية، وأن يطلق عليها اسم سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك الخليفة.
تستاهلون.
رائد الدبلوماسية البحرينية وأحد مؤسسيها الأوائل، الذي يسجل له تاريخها العريق الإخلاص في الأداء والتميز في العطاء، وهي سمة بحرينية أصيلة نرفع شعارها ونفاخر بها في كل المحافل. وختاماً، ومن منطلق اعتزازنا بما تحققه الدبلوماسية البحرينية وتقديراً للجهود البارزة لكوادرها برجالها ونسائها، نعلن بهذه المناسبة عن تخصيص 14 يناير من كل عام ليكون يوماً خاصاً للسلك الدبلوماسي، ولنحتفي فيه بإنجازاتهم في خدمة البحرين ورفعة شأنها. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
صاحب الجلالة.
Then Deputy Prime Minister His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa delivered a speech in which he expressed pride and appreciation for naming the institute after him. He highlighted that the kingdom celebrates the half century since the establishment of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. He said that this is an opportunity for the ministry's members to meet His Majesty the King and listen to his wise directions for the kingdom's interest and its people. His Highness presented the diplomatic march of the kingdom since the issuance of Decree 1 of the year 1969, issued by the late Sheikh Isa bin Salman Al Khalifa regarding the establishment of a foreign body that led to establishing the ministry. He said that day marks continuing the sovereignty of the country after ending the protection agreement with Britain in 1968. His Highness affirmed that the diplomatic march is not measured by number of years, but by the achievements made through regional and international challenges. He praised the directives of His Majesty the King King in addressing the border dispute between Bahrain and Qatar, and the International Court of Justice issuing its historic judgment that the Hawar Islands have always been part of Bahrain with its full sovereignty over the islands in accordance with international law. He addressed the challenges and the threats faced in the region and Bahrain by Iran, and the way the kingdom overcame these challenges, thanks to the negotiations of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa with regional and international countries. His Highness added that the kingdom developed its diplomatic march by following international standards, which developed its relations with various international countries throughout the history of the kingdom. His Highness said that Bahrain's modern diplomatic bureau has been able to keep up with the rapid changes and developments that characterize the field of international relations in recent decades. He asserted that such accomplishments have materialized as a result of the support of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. On the Arab and international levels, His Highness said that the Bureau's work yielded a number of key achievements, such as the selection of Bahrain being a member of the UN Security Council in the year 1998-1999, and Bahrain's presiding over the UN General Assembly in 2007-2008 through the appointment of the first Bahraini and Arab woman to occupy such a position. His Highness said that such moments in the history of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs reflect the hard work of Bahrainis on the Arab and international levels. He highlighted that the offices of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs are not a place of comfort and privilege, but are places in which citizens are ever vigilant and ready to defend the interests of their country. His Highness said that the Bahrain celebrates the launch of the diplomatic work, and its external relations with international countries are characterized by modernization, good neighborly relations, and a constant willingness to resolve conflicts peacefully, all of which reflect the values of the Bahraini people, such as their openness, hospitality, and generosity. He expressed hope as the ministry enters the second half of a century since its establishment under the leadership of His Majesty the King to remain a vehicle for time-honored traditions of international diplomacy as means for peaceful conflict resolution and cooperation and solidarity between the people on the international level. His Highness said that although the history of the ministry is relatively short and has experienced many challenges, and that its ambitions have pushed it to assert its presence regionally and internationally, he expressed pride in running the ministry for 3.5 decades and expressed appreciation for the efforts of Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmad Al Khalifa for successfully presiding over the ministry. His Highness then wished the ministry further success.
حكمها التاريخي القاضي بتأكيد تبعية جزر حوار كما كانت دائما للبحرين وبسيادتها التامة على الجزر طبقا للقانون الدولي. يعيد ذلك إلى ذاكرتنا التحديات والهديدات المتمثلة في الدعاءات والأطماع التوسعية الإيرانية في المنطقة وفي البحرين تحديدا، والتي تم التصدي لها في وقتها بفضل القيادة الحكيمة لصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة، التي أدارت المفاوضات بموازنة مع أطراف إقليمية ودولية توجت بالتأكيد على عروبة البحرين وسيادتها واستقلالها الناجز. إن مملكة البحرين التي استوحت مبادئها ومرجعياتها المؤسسة من الخبرات الدبلوماسية الدولية ومن حضارة وتقاليد شعب البحرين قد منحتها تلك العناصر المكانة المميزة في علاقاتها على الصعيد الخارجي على امتداد تاريخ البحرين المديد إن شاء الله. لقد استطاع جهازنا الدبلوماسي الحديث وبدعم من صاحب السمو الملك الأمير خليفة بن سلمان آل خليفة رئيس الوزراء الموقر، وصاحب السمو الملكي الأمير سلمان بن حمد آل خليفة ولي العهد نائب القائد الأعلى النائب الأول لرئيس مجلس الوزراء، مواكبة التحولات والتقلبات التي عرفتها العلاقات الدولية في العقود الأخيرة، مسهماً وفاعلاً إيجابياً على الأصعدة الثنائية والمتعددة، عارضاً وجهات نظر ومبادرات تاريخية هامة لقيت الترحيب والإشادة من قبل الدعوة إلى قيام مجلس التعاون لدول الخليج العربية وهو الصرح الصامد أمام الظروف التي تواجه منطقة الخليج العربي صاحب الجلالة، وفي إطار عملها ونشاطها على الساحتين العربية والدولية، فقد تكلل ذلك باختيار البحرين عضواً في مجلس الأمن الدولي عام 1998-1999، وبترأسها للجمعية العامة للأمم المتحدة عام 2007-2008، عندما تبوعت أول امرأة عربية بحرينية ذلك المنصب الدولي الهام. هذه بعض من المحطات الهامة في مسيرة عمل الوزارة وما واجهته خلالها من تحديات عبر فترة قصيرة من الزمن. لقد بذل جنون أوفياء من بناتنا ورجالنا في وزارة الخارجية الجهد الكبير في تنظيم العديد من المؤتمرات والملتقيات العربية والدولية التي استضافتها مملكة البحرين خلال العقود الماضية، غير أن ارتياحنا لأداء المنتسبين للخارجية داخل المملكة وفي الخارج لا يمنعنا من تحفيزهم بكل الوسائل لمضاعفة الجهد والتضحية نظراً لما تمر به العلاقات الدولية من تعقيدات وتحولات عميقة ومباغتة، وما تفرزه في الوقت الراهن من أزمات وتوترات يصعب التنبؤ دائماً بمداها. إن وزارة الخارجية في كل البلدان ليست مكاتب مريحة وامتيازات كما يتوهم البعض، بل هي في حقيقتها مثل التكنة التي يرابط فيها جنود في أهبة الاستعداد للدفاع عن حمى الوطن بكافة الوسائل. صاحب الجلالة صاحب السمو والسعادة والمعالي الحضور الكرام، والمملكة تحتفل اليوم بانطلاق العمل الدبلوماسي يخامرنا اليقين إن علاقاتنا مع الخارج الأقرب والأبعد اتسمت مع العصور بالاعتدال وحسن الجوار والجنوح إلى حل المشاكل بالوسائل السلمية في إطار الحوار المتكافئ. تلك هي بعض المقومات الثابتة لسياستنا الخارجية، وهي ليست غريبة على شعب مملكة البحرين المضياف والمنفتح برحابة على دول وشعوب العالم قاطبة دون تفريط في المبادئ. وإذ تدخل وزارة خارجية النصف الثاني من القرن من عمرها، فإننا ننظر إلى المستقبل بتفاؤل وأمل مع ما يلزم من الحيطة واليقظة. وستظل المملكة في عهد جلالتكم وفية للقيم الرفيعة والتقاليد العريقة والتجارب المضيئة التي أفرزها التراث الدبلوماسي العالمي باعتباره وسيلة للتقارب وفض النزاعات بالطرق السلمية والتعاون والتضامن بين الشعوب. قد يبدو عمر دبلوماسيتنا قصير، وهذا صحيح، لكنه عمر حافل بمواجهات وتحديات فرضها علينا طموحنا لنصبح دولة حاضرة في النظام الدولي والإقليمي وجزءاً فاعلاً من الأسرة العربية والإسلامية. وفي هذه المناسبة فإنه ليسعدني أن أعبر عن اعتزازي البالغ بإدارة وزارة الخارجية لثلاثة عقود، وأن أشيد بما بذله معالي الأخ الشيخ خالد بن أحمد بن محمد آل خليفة من جهود وما قام ويقوم به من دور مشهود في إدارة كفة الوزارة بكل اقتدار ونجاح لما فيه خير وطننا العزيز الذي نعمل لعزته ورفعة شأنه، مع تمنياتي لمعاليه بدام التوفيق. إن تاريخ دبلوماسيتنا لجدير بالتدوين، لنسترجع الأجيال القادمة صفحات مجيدة من معركة بناء الوطن وتمكينه من مقومات السيادة والانخراط في العصر بكل ثقة وتفاؤل وأمل. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
ويتشرف الآن معالي الشيخ خالد بن أحمد بن محمد آل خليفة.
The Minister of Foreign Affairs, Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmed bin Muhammad Al Khalifa, also delivered a speech in which he expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for receiving the attendees on this occasion. He stated that Bahraini diplomacy, as a result of the directives and support of His Majesty the King, His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, has become a model for effective and active diplomacy, which defends the interests of the kingdom, contributes to establishing its modern aspect, and strengthens its regional and international status. He added that Bahraini diplomacy during the era of His Majesty the King has achieved success in all aspects of development based on its heritage of the principles of national coexistence, mutual respect, joint work, and non-interference policy. The minister affirmed that the successes made in the past 50 years were a result of the elements of success available for Bahraini diplomacy, including leaders who prioritize citizens, people who believe in coexistence and openness and communication with all people, and competent diplomats who performed their duty optimally. The minister expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King for naming the Diplomatic Institute after His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa in appreciation for His Highness's status and achievements in the diplomatic field since the establishment of the ministry, and for dedicating the 14th of January as of every year as a day for the diplomatic corps. He affirmed continuing the role of developing the diplomatic work cadres and providing them expertise and knowledge to ensure the continuity of achievements and affirm the success of Bahraini diplomacy regionally and internationally.
في نصرة القضايا والمصالح العربية والإسلامية ومواجهة التحديات التي تواجه المجتمع الدولي لصياغة مستقبل أكثر أمنا واستقرارا للإنسانية. ولقد تمكنت الدبلوماسية البحرينية في ظل القيادة الحكيمة لجلالتكم من تحقيق قفزات هائلة وخطوات واسعة في كل مناحي التقدم والريادة، استنادا إلى إرثها القائم على مبادئ التعايش الوطني والاحترام المتبادل والعمل الجماعي المشترك وحسن الجوار وعدم التدخل في الشؤون الداخلية للدول الأخرى، وتوثيق أواصر الصداقة والتعاون مع جميع الدول والمجتمعات، والالتزام بميثاق الأمم المتحدة والقوانين والأعراف الدولية، والوقوف بصلابة إلى جانب الحق، والحرص على نشر السلام كمنهاج عمل تلتزم به في كل مواقفها وخطواتها وتتمسك به في جميع أدوارها وتحركاتها. إنما تحقق من نجاحات على مدى نصف قرن من الزمان جاء بفضل ما توفر للدبلوماسية البحرينية على امتداد تاريخها من مقومات النجاح، من قادة يضعون المواطن في قمة أولوياتهم ويسعون بكل جهدهم لتعزيز النهضة وتحقيق التقدم والازدهار، ومن شعب واع ومتحضر يؤمن بالتعايش والانفتاح والتواصل مع جميع الشعوب والثقافات، ورجال ونساء مخلصين ومدركين لعظم المسؤولية، ودبلوماسيين أكفاء استطاعوا وبكل اقتدار حمل الرسالة وأداء الأمانة في أن يكون لسانا ناطقا عن مملكة البحرين ومنجزاتها. سيدي حضرة صاحب الجلال، أعرب لجلالتكم حفظكم الله وبالأصالة عن نفسي وعن أخواني أعضاء السلك الدبلوماسي عن خالص شكري وامتناني لتفضلكم بإطلاق اسم سمو الشيخ محمد بن مبارك آل خليفة على المعهد الدبلوماسي، تقديراً لمكانة سموه العالية وإنجازاته الكبيرة في الميدان الدبلوماسي منذ تأسيس وزارة الخارجية وإلى يومنا هذا، ومباركتكم السامية بأن يكون يوم 14 من شهر يناير من كل عام يوماً للسلك الدبلوماسي، مؤكداً لجلالتكم بأننا سنواصل دورنا في تطوير كوادر العمل الدبلوماسي وتمكينهم من مختلف الأدوات بما يتواكب مع التطورات الراهنة، وإمدادهم بالخبرة والمعرفة لضمان
استمرارية هذه النجاحات، ولتواصل الدبلوماسية البحرينية مسيرتها على الساحتين الإقليمية والدولية، وتؤكد نجاحها وتفوقها في أداء مهامها والعمل وفق الثوابت الوطنية والأسس الراسخة لسياسة مملكة البحرين وتنفيذ أهدافها. حفظ الله المولى جلالتكم وسدد على طريق الخير خطاكم، إنه سميع مجيب، والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.
The minister then presented a commemorative gift to His Majesty the King. His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa received yesterday at Saqqir Palace former Foreign Minister and Secretary General of Asila Forum of Morocco and member of the Judging Committee of Isa Award for Serving Humanity Muhammad bin Isa. His Majesty praised the bilateral historic relations and the efforts of His Majesty King Mohammed VI of Morocco in enhancing relations between the two countries. His Majesty wished Morocco and its people further progress and prosperity. His Majesty also praised the role of Mohammed bin Isa in enhancing bilateral coordination through his membership in his award and his efforts to achieve its noble goals. His Majesty stressed the importance of spreading cultures in societies and support individual contributions in achieving comprehensive development. Mohammed bin Isa expressed thanks and appreciation to His Majesty the King and praised the strong relations between the two countries in all fields. Since the inception of Bahraini diplomacy 50 years ago, Bahrain has achieved a remarkable diplomatic progress as the government led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa has been keen on raising the kingdom's status regionally and internationally.
The government of Bahrain, led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa, has taken steps to enhance the international presence of Bahrain. Since the inception of Bahraini diplomacy 50 years ago, the kingdom has been able to form a clear and comprehensive vision of openness to the world to achieve the high interests of citizens. The kingdom's stances in the world came to affirm its Arabism, independence, and sovereignty in facing Iranian greed. The people of Bahrain do not accept an alternative for their Arabism. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister has adopted a historic stance against Iranian ambitions in Bahrain, which represented the most prominent and dangerous challenges Bahrain faced in the modern era, with the wise leadership of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, and ended with the world's recognition of the kingdom's rights, sovereignty, and Arabism. During the march of Bahraini diplomacy, Manama has been keen on diversifying relations with brotherly Gulf countries. The Arab world holds an important status in the Bahraini diplomacy's course of action. The government, led by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and with the directives of His Majesty the King, has been keen on developing joint Gulf-Arab work while bolstering cooperation between Bahrain and brotherly countries in various fields. Bahrain has been keen on strengthening cooperation with Asian, African, and European countries all year round. His Royal Highness the Prime Minister meets with the senior officials and ambassadors of these countries and discusses with them the best means of bolstering bilateral relations. His Royal Highness has also gained the respect and appreciation of the international community as a result of his wise vision and keenness to strengthen Bahrain's foreign relations and his efforts to promote peace and enhance sustainable development, which was evident through His Royal Highness's receiving many global awards and medals in appreciation for his development achievements. The government, under the leadership of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, has also been keen on developing relations with regional and international organizations, at the forefront of which is the UN and its specialized programs, evident through His Royal Highness's initiatives to launch an award named after him for sustainable development, which made Bahrain a country that gives special importance to achieving sustainable development goals.
His Majesty the King's representative for charity works and youth affairs, chairman of the Supreme Council for Youth and Sports and president of Bahrain Olympic Committee, His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad Al Khalifa, praised the service of the Minister of Education, Dr. Majid bin Ali Al Nu'aymi, in the field of education, which improved the educational march in Bahrain. He affirmed that the minister is keen on developing education and preserving the public money. His Highness valued the quick response of the Minister of Education to implement the outcomes of the 2018 Youth Summit, held under the patronage of His Royal Highness the Crown Prince, Deputy Supreme Commander and First Deputy Prime Minister Prince Salman bin Hamad Al Khalifa, by cancelling homeworks and benefiting from sports facilities in 212 schools belonging to the Ministry of Education. His Highness praised Dr. Al Nu'aymi's positive engagement with the outcomes of the Youth Summit and described them as important landmarks in the path towards development of Bahrain's education system. His Highness added that Al Nu'aymi's efforts provide students with opportunities to carry out their preferred activities and to maximize the use of sports facilities in schools. Dr. Al Nu'aymi also met with the Minister of Youth and Sports, Ayman bin Tawfiq Al Mu'ayyad, to discuss how the Ministry of Youth and Sports, as well as the surrounding communities, can make use of the sports facilities in schools. The two ministers also discussed how they may coordinate their efforts in building multi-purpose sports centers and football pitches. Ayman bin Tawfiq expressed appreciation of Dr. Al Nu'aymi's positive engagement with His Highness Sheikh Nasser bin Hamad's vision and the recommendations of the Youth Summit, which reflected his keen interest in developing the skills of the Bahraini youth. Under the patronage of the Deputy Prime Minister, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak Al Khalifa, and in the presence of the Deputy Prime Minister Sheikh Khalid bin Abdullah Al Khalifa, the Chairman of the Shura Council Ali bin Saleh Al Saleh, and a number of ministers, members of the diplomatic corps accredited to the kingdom, as well as senior officials and invitees, the Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmad bin Muhammad Al Khalifa inaugurated the 50 Years of Diplomacy exhibition held at Bahrain National Museum. On the occasion, His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak made a statement in which he expressed pleasure in celebrating the golden jubilee of Bahraini diplomacy, expressing pride in administering the Ministry of Foreign Affairs for over three decades. He stated that the celebration that documents the history and march of Bahraini diplomacy for half a century represents continuing national sovereignty and embodies the contributions of the ministry to establish diplomatic ties with brotherly and friendly countries. He added that Bahrain's policy and its relations have gained Bahrain's appreciation and respect to become a country that is present regionally and internationally. He hailed the efforts of the Minister of Foreign Affairs in holding this exhibition, expressing thanks and appreciation for all who contributed to organizing it. The Minister of Foreign Affairs delivered a speech in which he expressed pleasure and pride in the honor of Bahraini diplomacy gained in His Majesty King Hamad bin Isa Al Khalifa's dedication of January 14th of every year as a day for diplomatic corps. The minister expressed thanks and gratitude to His Highness Sheikh Mohammed bin Mubarak for patronizing this exhibition, asserting his appreciation for the President of Bahrain Authority for Culture and Antiquities, Sheikh Mai bint Muhammad Al Khalifa, for her efforts and cooperation with the Ministry of Foreign Affairs to achieve success for the exhibition. The minister noted that the exhibition will continue to introducing the history of Bahraini diplomacy and its various stages. Bahrain has achieved a remarkable diplomatic progress, and today the Ministry of Foreign Affairs celebrates 50 years of diplomacy through an exhibition in Bahrain's National Museum, showcasing the milestones of its progress and a timeline of the journey that raised the kingdom's status regionally and internationally.
50 years of diplomacy, 50 years of stability, 50 years of wisdom from His Majesty and from His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. And this is what where we get our advice and directives from, and we move forward and we can see our country most respectful and most respected country in the world among peace-loving and hard-working nations.
Diplomats, officials, and ambassadors from all countries took part in this special celebration, hailing the wonderful relationships established with Bahrain and its clear and comprehensive vision of openness to the world.
Bahrain is the first GCC country that was represented and a member of the UN Security Council. It is the first country that have nominated a lady to head the General Assembly of the UN. If that is not, if that doesn't tell anything about the diplomacy, nothing else will. It is a diplomacy that spread or try to spread the peace and the security of the entire world.
Pleasure for me to see so much British official involvement, so many British diplomats and statesmen in, woven into the history of Bahraini diplomacy as well. We work very well together in so many different ways. So 50 years on, we're just looking forward to the next 50 years.
50 years of diplomacy means 50 years of engagement, means 50 years of being on the world screen, means 50 years of partnering with different countries as well as with the United Nations. Today we have seen that the United Nations is really part of the history of modern Bahrain since 1970 to 71, where we had the UN come to Bahrain and visit, and then a historical decision was taken to accept Bahrain as a member in 1971 of the United Nations.
Bahrain celebrates the launch of the diplomatic work and external relations with international countries, characterized by moderation, good neighborly relations, and a constant willingness to resolve conflicts peacefully, all of which reflect the values of the Bahraini people, such as their openness, hospitality, and generosity. Reporting for Bahrain International, I'm Hiba Abdul Ghaffar. The Council of Representatives held its fifth meeting of the first ordinary session of the fifth legislative term, chaired by Council Speaker Fawzi Abdullah Zainal. Followed the conclusion of the meeting, Secretary General of the Council Rashid Mohammed Bounejma made the following statement. At the beginning of the meeting, the Council reviewed incoming messages from the Shura Council and took the following decisions. An incoming message from the Chairman of the Shura Council on a draft law on the regulation of buildings has been referred to the Public Facilities and Environment Committee and to the Legislative and Legal Affairs Committee. Another incoming message from the Chairman of the Shura Council on a draft law regarding the regulation of print media and publishing has been referred to the Services Committee and to Legislative and Legal Affairs Committee. Concerning a draft law regarding the regulation of labor market, the Council referred an incoming message from the Chairman of the Shura Council to the Services Committee and to the Legislative and Legal Affairs Committee. The Council then approved an extension of the government's action plan for the years 2019-2022 for 10 days following its date of expiry. Regarding the fifth article of the reply to the Royal Speech Committee's report, the Council decided to delegate the office of the Council to include the representative's modification. The Honorary President of the Good Word Society, His Highness Sheikh Isa bin Ali bin Khalifa Al Khalifa, opened the Gulf Children's Forum, held under his patronage for the ninth consecutive year in the presence of representatives of diplomatic missions to the Kingdom of Bahrain. His Highness affirmed that this forum is an innovative idea, yet emphasizes the commonalities that bind the people of the GCC countries. His Highness expressed pride in this initiative that has developed over the years in order to instill noble values in new generations. He also emphasized that the Kingdom has occupied the top position in the field of human capital because the Kingdom has paid great attention to investing in the Bahraini citizens. Due to the directives of His Majesty the King, the efforts of His Royal Highness the Prime Minister and His Royal Highness the Crown Prince. His Highness added that international human development reports have indicated the positive development in Bahrain, its success in implementing the development goals, and its strong orientation towards the implementation of the Goals of Sustainable Development 2030. Minister of Foreign Affairs Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmad bin Muhammad Al Khalifa received today the U.S. Special Representative for Iran and Senior Policy Advisor to the Secretary of State, Brian Hook. Sheikh Khalid bin Ahmad welcomed Hook and affirmed the deep historic and strategic Bahrain-U.S. ties and expressed pride in the ongoing development of these ties in political, economic, and security fields. The minister stressed the Kingdom's full support and solidarity with the United States' efforts in confronting Iran's policies across the region. For his part, Hook expressed a pride in the bilateral ties between the two countries and peoples and wished the Kingdom further progress and prosperity. Minister of Education Dr. Majid bin Ali Al Nuaimi inaugurated the 44th annual Scout Camp held this year under the theme Scout and Centennial Education in the presence of the Ministry of Youth and Sports Affairs Ayman bin Tawfiq Al Muayyad and the chairman of Bahrain Commercial Facilities Company Abdul Rahman Fakhro. During the ceremony, Assistant Under Secretary for Education Services and Student Activities and Vice President of Bahrain Scouts Association Dr. Sheikh Yusuf Al Jib noted the achievements of the Scouts movement, which includes the Scouts' participation in community activities. A number of previous heads of Scout education departments and Scouts with special needs were honored during the ceremony, as well as Al-Hidayah Al-Khalifa School and Abu Bakr Al-Siddiq School. The Minister of Youth and Sports Affairs praised the efforts of the Ministry of Education to serve Bahrain youth and asserted the importance of promoting cooperation between the two ministries to serve the joint national goals in the field of youth development. The Minister of Education affirmed the importance of Scouts movement, which helps Scouts develop character and ethics and encourages them to participate in volunteer work. The Parliamentary Committee for the Study of the Government Action Plan 2019-2022 held a meeting chaired by the Second Deputy Speaker of the Representatives' Council, Ali Al-Zayed, in the presence of a number of Council's members. The meeting discussed the Government Action Plan 2019-2022 and the government statement submitted by His Royal Highness the Prime Minister, Prince Khalifa bin Salman Al Khalifa. The Council members presented the available paperwork, including His Majesty the King's Royal Speech, during the meeting and analyzed its content. The presentation included the Kingdom's Economic Vision 2030 and the Fiscal Balance Program, as well as the National Consensus Dialogue Report and a number of the Gulf Development Support Program projects.